Hello, everyone. This is Thewey. Today I am doing a playtest of Chameleander. This is the new version of Chameleander. He's a one warrior faction. My version of the Vagabond basically does not replace the Vagabond, just a different take on that kind of mechanic in a board game like Root. Chameleander goes around helping people recruit, helping factions build their buildings. And as Chameleander goes along, Chameleander's ego grows. And that's how you score points with Chameleander. So, all right, cats go first. Let's go ahead and put wood at each sawmill, which is just the one, of course. We're gonna craft Charm Offensive. Get that card draw up. We're gonna give up on the swap meet dream here too, I think. We are going to build a sawmill in Rabbit. We will go ahead and overwork that Rabbit and then build a recruiter. Where will we build this recruiter? We'll build it here. Okay. So that's that. It is start of evening. We will draw a card. I did get 2 points for building those buildings. Draw a card and give... Oh, shoot. I don't know if I shuffled this. Let me shuffle that. Okay, we'll draw a card and give a point to the Vagabond. We're doing Despot Infamy. It's fine. It's fine. Then I'll draw one card. All right, Vagabond. I mean, best case scenario is that I go to this mouse clearing right there, or this one, I guess, either one of those, and I draw the hammer so that I can craft this tea right away. That's probably best case scenario. I think I'd rather get this far off one out of the way first, so we're gonna slip there, and we're gonna take the ferry over here. Draw a card. Oh, whoa, what a thing to top deck. Let's go ahead and explore this ruin, get another sword, love it. I only have one boot right now, so I don't really feel like going hostile. Probably should have done that rabbit quest while I was there, but I did not, so I'll just have to do it later. Okay, let's draw a card. Hold on, before I draw that card, do I want to aid the cats? Get a little aiding action in. Yeah, sure, whatever. Give them a bird card, holy moly. Best friends, right there. Arbiter and Marquise. So 1 point for Charm Offensive, 1 point for exploring, and 1 point for aiding. We'll now draw a card and end the turn. All right, Chameleander, let me explain some of the differences in this version. Okay, Chameleander. I don't think there's anything we're gonna craft. I think we might just boast to the birds a couple times. Unless we want to... No, I don't think we want to do anything else, really. I think let's maybe pump up the cats. Just to mess with some people, I guess. Let's go over here. But you know what? Maybe I do want to get some workshops down for the cats. I can't really control whether they do that or not, though. Okay, you know what? Screw it. We're gonna stay right here. I'm gonna use my three actions to recruit three cats. And then I'm gonna boast to the birds twice. That'll get me two ego tokens and score me a total of 2 points. Then I will draw four cards and turn it over to the rats. Okay, rats, they raise. That doesn't really happen this turn. They get two warriors. We choose a new mood. I feel like Vagabond's just gonna take all the ruins, which they probably will. Let's go rowdy. No. We should go grandiose. Yeah. Getting our action economy online, people. We are gonna craft this hammer. For the hammer. Okay, we are taking our prowess actions first, so we are going to attack this cat. Do you ambush? They could. But they won't. Okay, cats are going to recover that cat. And we lose one as well. Then the rats are gonna go over here and not battle because they're. I mean, it could save actions later on, but I don't want the warlord to be too exposed right now. But we are gonna go ahead and build a stronghold here. Okay, not going to incite. Let's draw a card and turn it over to Marquise. All right, Marquise. Get a wood at both of our sawmills. Going to build a recruiter here for two wood, getting us 2 points. We will recruit. And then, I mean, I could be a jerk and I could take that, the fairy. But if I do that, then the arbiter is going to be chilling in my homelands, and I kind of want him to skedaddle. So I'm not going to do that. Being a jerk does have its virtues, but not right now. Okay, let's go ahead and I guess march. Somehow we got a lot of cats. So let's just march them a little bit. Going to charm offensive draw. Oh, the rat should have gotten a press point. We will give the rats one more point with that charm offensive, and then we will draw two more cards. And look, I have to discard right now. Get rid of this. Well, where am I most likely to get hit? I don't have any mouse cards. This is sad. I'm only in two fox clearings. I'm in a lot more rabbit clearings, so I'll get rid of this fox dominance card. All right, next. We get three refreshed items. We are going to slip on the fairy. Love it. Let's go over here. We draw a card as part of that fairy ride, and let's explore this ruin. Ooh, a bag. You know, I'm never sad about getting it back as the Arbiter. Always afraid I'm gonna drop all of my things, so. Yep, yep. Okay. And I could just keep this. Well, okay. I am in a rabbit clearing. Let's go ahead and quest. Expelling the bandits. Let's see what the next one is. Tea and boot. Cool, cool. I have too many cards right now anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and just take a point. Okay. I got a charm offensive point, an explore point, and an aid point, an explore point, and a quest point. Okay. All right. Let's draw a card. Discard down. Goodbye, informants. I mean, that wouldn't be terrible for Arbiter, being able to pull out ambush cards on my one draw. But yeah, we'll toss it. I'm never going to get a double hammer, so that was a conversation not worth entertaining. Okay, we got Chameleander. Cats only have one crafting piece. Rats have two. Still not enough to craft Propaganda Bureau. But I think I would like to end this turn in a place where I could. I think what I'll do is I will slip on over here. Go ahead and, oh look, I could craft this sword if I were just close enough. So we're here. I'll give the cats an opportunity to take the build action if they would like. I think they do want to. They'll build a sawmill. They gain 2 points for that. I, as Chameleander, get an ego token and gain 1 point for that. Got two more actions left. I think what I'll do is maybe be nice to the rats. Hey, rat boys, I'll clean out this cat for you. If you promise not to hurt me. So I attack here. Do you ambush cats? They do not. Okay, cats will discard a fox card to save their cat. It is evening. I will boast to the birds to gain 2 points. Now I draw 3 cards. Discarding 1. And go from there. It's going to be an interesting game because the cats don't have a lot of crafting pieces. The rats do sometimes have some, but they're not so spread out. In a game with Eerie, Chameleander crafts like a wildman. But this one's going to be a little different. All right, so no raisings happening. Going to go ahead and do the recruit thing, so 2 at the Warlord, and then 1 at both strongholds. Choose a different mood. I think we'll go rowdy. Crafting, we're gonna craft Eerie Emigre. So fun, we'll have even more battles as Warlord. Okay. All right, commanding the hundreds. I mean, maybe I can carve out some more space for me. But also, I probably need to slow down the cats. They've been helped by... they've been helped by Chameleander just a little too much for my liking. So I think maybe over here... command one. And then our prowesses. No one's crafted anything, that's right. And our prowesses, we attack here. Do the cats ambush? They do not. Cats will save their own. I like playing benevolent medical cats. Just always saving their own. Promised Chameleander we wouldn't hit him this turn. He did help us out. I mean, should we honor that promise? Guess we could. But I think what we'll do regardless is leave a little rat here and we'll come back. We're not going to attack. But since we're rowdy and Chameleander has several faction pieces there, we'll get to draw three cards. So that's nice. Okay, kick it over to cats. Cats get an astonishing three wood. Yeah, the cats are going to be a big problem in this game because of Chameleander pumping them up. I mean, they're everywhere. They've just gotten a free sawmill. They got like three free cats. This could be a problem. Chameleander likes creating problems, like sowing discord. Okay, I think I could either build a recruiter or a sawmill. It might be fun building a recruiter. Yeah, let's build a recruiter. Building a recruiter for 3 points. Then we will recruit. Oh my gosh, we are. Move. But whatever. We could march. Don't really feel like we need the extra card draw. We could go after the rats. We've got a bunch of bird cards. I think we're gonna play it cool though. Sit back a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, I don't feel like there's much else to do with my actions. So we are gonna just, I mean, do I wanna redistribute it all? I mean, I could just do a little march over here. One there, one there. Okay, yeah, that's fine. We are not gonna do charm offensive. We're just gonna draw two cards. Turn it over to the Arbiter. Arbiter gets their three. Gonna ferry on over here. Explore. Beautiful. We get our hammer. And a point. We'll go ahead and craft a T. For 2 points. And I think I might do something wild and I do two wild things. Let's go ahead and aid the cats twice for 2 points. And then I'm not even in a rabbit clearing, so I can't do the quest thing. And that's for the best, really, to not do that quest, lest I have too few items. Okie dokie, let's draw a card and end the turn. All right, Chameleander. Chameleander is very disappointed that no one is building crafting resources. Chameleander is just going to hunker down there, though, and we're going to build boat builders. Let's not give the warlord any prowess items. Let's increase our mobility. Okay. I do want to go over here, though, for the first move. And then I want to cajole... Well, I'm going to drag a rat over with me, too. And I want to cajole the warlord into building here. The warlord will accept. And because he accepts, I get 2 points. And then I think I'm gonna pump up the warlord a bit. Recruit two rats over here. It is evening. I could boast to the birds, but I really don't want to. I will draw two cards. Okay, on to warlord. Raising is not a thing in this game. We are going to recruit two at the warlord and then one at each stronghold. Okay. No anointing needs to happen. Let's choose a different mood. What mood are we in? I feel like we're in a cat murdering mood. I think I missed an oppress point last turn. Most certainly did. Okay. Yes, I feel like I'm in a cat murdering mood, and so I feel like I should go murder some cats. So let's do it. We're wrathful today. Let's go ahead and craft a boot. Lovely. Well, okay, we're not crafting the boot quite yet. We gotta do Eerie Emigre. Let's run down here and attack these cats. Do you ambush? Yes. The cats ambush, and this might be the end of the warlord. Holy moly. Let's go. Oh my gosh. No. The warlord's turn is just ruined due to bad math. Cats are going to save their cats because four of them died. Wow. This was insane. Warlord's turn is basically down the toilet right now, but we are going to get a boot. Let's redistribute a little bit. And no advancing the warlord because the warlord died before the command step even happened. Before the prowess step even happened. The advance the warlord step. So, yeah, fun times. Let's draw a card. Well, hold on. We do oppress two clearings, so there's one little pity point for warlord overlords. Kick it over to cats. Okay, I think the cats have an opportunity here, potentially. There are no... All the warriors of the cats are on the board right now, so we don't need to spend any actions recruiting, which means we can devote a lot of our time to building and to violence. Cards right now. Let's just give the warlord freaking hell. But first, we are going to build. If I build a recruiter, I increase my card draw and therefore my possibility of getting bird cards. So let's try that. I know the sawmill heavy strat, and I respect it. And that's what I usually do. 1, 2, 3 points. Okay, now I got 2 actions left. How best to murder the rats? I think probably like 1, 2. And then the last action, 3. Four. And then we'll spend a bird card to battle here. Do you ambush? You do not. Oh, 3-3. Wow, lots of bloodshed in these rolls. Do I save them with the bird card? Probably do. I got enough recruiters though. I could just use the bird card to recruit and then they'd all be out again. We're gonna let them die. Spend another bird card to battle here. 3-1. And then I think we're gonna go ahead and spend a bird card to recruit. We're gonna leave this as bait. I think the warlord will go for it. Okay. I mean, it's not so much as bait as I don't want to lose 2 cats in this fight. I'd rather lose 1. Okay, it is evening. Let's draw a card with charm offensive and give a point to rats. And let's draw 3 cards. Ooh, rabbit partisans. Love it. Fox partisans. Coffin makers, let's get rid of coffin makers. Okay, arbiter, we refresh all things. Where do we go now? I think we slip over here, grab our birthright boot, gaining a point. We are going to Okay. We're going to move over here. Craft a T. For 2 points. We are going to is it time to be violent towards the cats? We've got our 2 boots. Got 3 swords. And the cats are doing incredibly well. Yeah, I think it's time. All right. We declare war on the cats. Do you ambush? They certainly could. Are there any other mouse spots that concern me. Not really. Let's go ahead and ambush. Gonna damage a boot and a torch. One. And now we are hostile with the cats. Now we will battle again. Okay, that's 3 points. Okay, excellent. Arbiter will draw a card. And we'll go on. All right, Chameleander. There are still 3 strongholds. The cats did not prevail, so this is great news. Means that we can finally craft our propaganda bureau. But what do we want to do after that? Arbiter is soaring in the lead. I don't know if Chameleander wants to do anything about that, though. I think Chameleander would rather help the warlord get on the warlord's feet. Let's go ahead and we're just going to stay right here. We're going to craft this propaganda bureau. No, I am going to slip over here. Yeah. Okay. So crafting propaganda bureau. I'm here for the start of my turn. I am going to do this fun little trick with propaganda bureau and Chameleander. I am going to propaganda bureau one of these cats with Chameleander. Instead. So we get to place our last ego token and score 3 points. That's fun, because usually when Chameleander is taking actions, Chameleander is like boosting up other people. But this one is actually a way that Chameleander can harm someone and still get the ego cranked up. Okay, so I've got 2 more actions. Let's go ahead and use both of them to get more warriors. I'm going to be drawing 1 card this turn. I'd rather draw 2. So let's go ahead and spend an ego token to recruit for the warlord an additional time. Okay, boast to the birds time. Not gonna. We'll just draw our 2 cards and send it over to the warlord. Okay, warlord, raising is not a thing. We will recruit 1 at each of the strongholds. Then we will we'll get our warlord out. Oh my. Everyone's running away with it. Warlord needs to do something to slow this game down. What is it, though? Is it attacking Arbiter? I mean, we want to get 3 clearings. That's for sure. And attacking Arbiter is not going to help us do that. I think we are going to go stubborn. Okay. Still gotta do Eerie Immigre. I think we're gonna just send a rat over here and attack the cat here. Cat, do you ambush? You do not. Okay, since we're stubborn, we take no casualties, but the cats will rescue that cat. Okay. All right, we got two command. I think we are gonna craft tunnels. Yeah, why not? And we've got one more command. Let's use it to go over here. Now we are going to advance the warlord over here and attack. Do you ambush cats? You do not. 3-0. They will rescue those cats. I've got one more prowess left. I've got my 3-4 oppression though, but I do want to do more damage to these cats. So we're gonna go over here and attack. Three zero. Oh, we like these. Alrighty, goodbye, cats. Get a point as warlord. We're pressing 4 clearings, which is 2 points for us. Hopefully that was enough of a peg to knock them down. Let's go ahead and draw a card. Okay. What will the cats do in response? Cats are gonna craft rabbit partisans. Oh man, they only have 2 sawmills right now. Don't listen to me. Don't follow my example. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and craft, or build rather, a sawmill. Yeah, seems good. For 2 points. That is just like arbiter fodder, but like if I would have built it here, then there go 2 sawmills. So I think I made the right choice of building spot. Let's go ahead and recruit. And I think I will march. No, marching is not a good idea. Marching is not 3 moves, everyone. It's only 2. Yeah, I could move some folks. Move. No, I don't want to move anyone. Yeah, maybe I do. Let's move here and here. Okay, now we are going to charm offensive. Give a point to rats. And then we'll draw 2 cards. All right, on to Vagabond. Fresh absolutely everything. What is the play? I think the play might be just to like go into here and just wail on the cats. So yeah, we're gonna slip over here. Drawing a card. And then we are going to battle the cats. Three, two. Cats will rescue those cats. Arbiter will take two hits. And gain 1 point. They will attack again. Okay, that is 3 points for Arbiter. And Arbiter takes... Wait, hold on. There should be one more thing left. Now we take it out. So that actually gets me an extra point. Because I only had two swords and I dealt three hits accidentally. So that is the proper accounting. Holy moly, Arbiter 21 points. Even in Despite Infamy, violent vagabonds can prosper. Okay, now Arbiter is going to draw a card and end the turn. All right, Chameleander. Chameleander is going to skip on over here, craft a sword and a boot for 3 points using the strongholds. If no one does anything about the Arbiter will win. Seems like the Arbiter is going to go into the forest next time, though. So I don't really think that there's much that needs to be done. Okay. Chameleander is going to spend the first action going over here. We are going to prop bureau a cat, which will then, we're going to prop bureau a cat and replace it with an ego token, gaining 3 points for that. Again, prop bureau, amazing for Chameleander. Okay, so we've taken two actions. Now we'll do the third one to attack. The cats. The cats do not have an ambush. Alright, so Chameleander is a warrior that can deal up to two hits, even though we rolled the three. Goodbye this cat, goodbye this sawmill. We gain a point. And in order to take hits, Chameleander either discards cards or gets rid of the ego token. So we're going to discard a card for the one hit the cat dealt. Okay, we could call it there, but I kind of want to draw some more cards, I think. So I'm thinking let's spend an ego token to move over here. Okay, some of these have started to stack up, I think. Yep. Now I'm going to spend another ego token to take the fairy. And we'll go over here and draw one card because of that. That seems like a good place to end the turn. Let's go ahead and draw three cards. And switch it over to rats. Okay. Rats get two rats at the mouse and then, at the warlord. One at each stronghold. Chameleander has just crafted a couple things. They won't improve our score yet, but it would be a shame if Arbiter got them. So I think we'll want to go ahead and loot Mr. Chameleander here. What's the best way to do that for us? We need a new mood. Is this the time we go in and just try to like tear Catropolis down? He does have rabbit partisans, so that would be an actual nightmare. I need one more clearing. Think I'd like to conquer this clearing and then get the warlord out. Let's get wrathful. And then we do Eerie Emigre. So this is how we're gonna try to loot Chameleander. Move and attack. Do you ambush Chameleander? We're not so worried about it. We're not gonna ambush. I do deal two hits though, and you get an item of your choosing. Okay, we've got two command now, so let's go ahead and go here for the first, and then we will loot again. Okay, setting ourselves up for a command and prowess breakthrough. Okay, let's go ahead and use our first prowess to go up here and attack the cats. Okay, so we dealt four hits, and they are going to save all those cats. One point for Warlord. I did that right. Okay. Second prowess, we're gonna go back here. So I do get my full oppress points. Yep, that all looks good. Let's go ahead and draw a card and end the turn. All right, cats. Cats have been shoved into a corner. They do have most of their cats on the board, though. They only have their starting buildings. Crazy. Let's go ahead and give them a wood. They will craft. Oh, looks like that card Warlord drew was the last one. We are going to go ahead and. Ah, dang it. The boots are both crafted. We will not craft a boot. Okay. Well, I trust the Arbiter is going to the forest. Chameleander is a little bit too far away with for me to deal with. Think what we're gonna do is give the warlord some help. So we move. We're gonna battle. Any ambush? Nope. Ugh, 1-1. Really? We're gonna battle again. 3-0. That's what I'm talking about. All right. Whew. Warlord is sparse in warriors right now. We are going to charm offensive. Give a point to the rats out of spite, and then draw a card. All right, Arbiter, go into the forest. The cats are our money makers, so we're gonna go hang out over here in Cat Corner. Kitty Corner. Okay, good, good. Let's draw a card. And discard it, because it was garbage. Okay. Chameleander. Chameleander's in a great spot, honestly. Who are we most worried about? I mean, it's probably the Arbiter, because he could literally just come out next turn and probably win. Which is, of course, not great for us. What can we do? We can cajole, prop bureau, and boast. This could get us a total of 8 points. Get us to 25. That's pretty great. Do we need to slow anyone down as Chameleander? Probably not. I mean, the one we want to slow down is Arbiter, and he's in the forest, so. But, I mean, there are these juicy, juicy strongholds. I think I probably got to visit them. Let's go over here. We are going to craft swap meet. Guess I didn't have to give up on the swap meet dream. And let's go ahead and also craft a crossbow for a point. Commander's great at crafting when the situation presents itself. Okay, first action. We are going to attack here. Warlord does not ambush. 2-2. That's all I needed. 1 point for Chameleander. And then I take a hit. I don't like that. But, oh well. Let's just get rid of an ego token. So Warlord gets a point for that too. So that's action one. Action two is to go over here. Action three. This feels mean. This doesn't feel right. Nah, we're gonna leave that. Let's move over here instead. Going to cajole the rats with a third action to build a stronghold. They will. So I get 2 points. I will spend an ego token to take an additional action. We're going to use the fairy and go over here for that sweet extra card. And then I'm going to go ahead and prop bureau this rat to get another 2 points. Is evening. I'm just gonna leave it there. I'm gonna draw 3 cards. Guys, Chameleander might win for the first time in a long time. This is great news. Okay. Warlord. Let's get our people at each stronghold. then let's replace one with the Warlord. I think we probably need to go Relentless. Gonna go ahead and craft a bag. After we do Eerie Emigre, of course, which we actually cannot fulfill Eerie Emigre, so let's just use it to move a little bit. Okay. It is daylight. I've got 3 command actions. Let's go 1 and then 2. We're gonna loot ya. No ambush, go ahead. Takes the crossbow. 1 more command action. Go ahead and build. Okay, now we've got our relentless actions. We got 3 prowess. A little too late, really, but let's. I think we gotta hit Chameleander. Let's go here. Not attack. Let's go here and attack. Do you ambush? I will counter ambush. Two. With my bonus move, I think I'm just going to go back here. Draw a card. Oh man, I'm in a pickle. Got 3 clearings though. Press for 2. I am not doing my 3rd prowess. Draw a card. All right, cats. The rats just lightened up Chameleander. Could go in and get some points. Let's start off by getting some wood. I think we gotta build over work build. I mean, that's what we gotta do. Build for a point and a wood. Overwork to get another wood. And then build another sawmill. Yeah. So that was for 2 points. All right. Cats aren't doing terribly, but all right. Well, let's draw. Just let's give the rats a VP for charm offensive and then draw our card and go. Okay, Arbiter, do you just up and win this? Probably. And get 5 points of quests. Then they just need 4 more points. Which they can probably get from here. So yeah, let's do it. Arbiter will slip into here. Gonna get 2 points off that quest. Oh my, we cannot actually, we can't do that. Well, shoot. Miscounted the boots. Let's go ahead and just slip into here then and whack away. Wow, 3-0. That is 3-0 cats field hospitaled. And 1 point for Vagabond. And we attack again for 2 points. We're out of boots, out of luck. Yeah. Arbiter did not win that. Maybe could have, probably could have, just miscounted. All right, well, we'll draw a card and send it over to Chameleander. Now, can Chameleander win it? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points. We can get 5 if we can get those two down. Each of those will cost a card to get down. Let's go ahead and swap meet with someone. We'll swap meet Vagabond, since he is the points leader. Okay, bird card, lovely. We'll take a bird card. Okay. If Chameleander can take the ferry, then I think we can win. And that's pretty easy since I have boat builders. So, gonna skip over here. Gonna cajole the rats into building a stronghold. I don't think they will. They're a little bit wary right now. So we will get 2 points that way. We're going to ride the ferry over here with action 2, draw a card. We'll prop bureau a cat here for 3 points. And then we'll go to even, well, then I need to spend 1 to really just take any of these actions. Let's invite a cat over. Let's invite a rat over. I can recruit since he's adjacent to me. Then we'll go to evening and I will boast to the birds to get the last 3 victory points. Well, I only needed 2, but okay, fun. Really interesting game where the cats got really pumped up really fast. We're looking like a huge threat. They were summarily dealt with by the rats, and those two got into a forever war. The Arbiter and Chameleander were just not worth the time to police to either the rats or the cats due to action economy. And for Warlord specifically, it doesn't help with the press. So, wow. Wild and wicked game. Okay, great. Thanks everyone for watching. If you are not following me already or subscribed to my channel, you know, I invite you to do so. Arbiter did not win that. Maybe could have, probably could have, just miscounted. All right, well, we'll draw a card and send it over to Chameleander. Now, can Chameleander win it? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points. We can get 5 if we can get those two down. Each of those will cost a card to get down. Let's go ahead and swap meet with someone. We'll swap meet Vagabond, since he is the points leader. Okay, bird card, lovely. We'll take a bird card. Okay. If Chameleander can take the ferry, then I think we can win. And that's pretty easy since I have boat builders. So, gonna skip over here. Gonna cajole the rats into building a stronghold. I don't think they will. They're a little bit wary right now. So we'll get 2 points that way. We're going to ride the ferry over here with action 2, draw a card. We'll prop Bureau a cat here for 3 points. And then we'll go to even. Well, then I need to spend 1 to really just take any of these actions. Let's invite a cat over. Let's invite a rat over. I can recruit since he's adjacent to me. Then we'll go to evening and I will boast to the birds to get the last 3 victory points. Well, I only needed 2, but okay, fun. Really interesting game where the cats got really pumped up really fast. We're looking like a huge threat. They were summarily dealt with by the rats, and those two got into a forever war. The Arbiter and Chameleander were just not worth the time to police to either the rats or the cats due to action economy. And for Warlord specifically, it doesn't help with the press. So, wow. Wild and wicked game. Okay, great. Thanks everyone for watching. If you are not following me already or subscribe to my channel, you know, I invite you to do so. Helps me out a bunch. Thanks for watching.